They're looking forward to seeing if they can get off to a good start. The Jack Jumpers, they go to McVay. And good defence straight away from Hook Porty. Travers looks to push the tempo. Good start. Travers, we believe, is playing with a bit of a sort of hot spot in his shin, playing sore. That he's going to continue to play without some of his other teammates as Golding straight off the bat.
Not great, but you know what? This is the best way to get you going. You see that ball go in the rim. Free throws, both. Well, one goes in. Hit that ball to go in the rim.
And just needed a wait. Yeah, I should have waited.
Yeah. I'm learning, Drew.
United can get out of the box. And there's Ian Clark in the starting lineup.
Well, he is the polar opposite to Jordan Clark.
No, they need to come down and find Milton Doyle. Get him, let him touch the ball. Even if he doesn't shoot it, he needs to touch it to feel a part of it.
It's been a scratchy start from the Jack Jumpers. You might expect the timeout to be coming soon.
More than scratchy.
There it is.
It is. And there are critical moments in games. You're down eight, only scored the single free throw. And that's what Copes was 100% spot on.
They're stacked. Travis, who rebounds and plays any position, they are stacked, Drew.
They are. And that's an important play, Jack McVay.
Protected the basket. And now Golding in transition. Here's Travis again. Great defense at the other end for Milton Doyle.
It's like they put those whistles away.
And you come into the venue and you don't know the scores.
The play on Magnum was a foul, but.
And then Hook Porty. This is why they're first and third in defensive rating in the competition as McVay knocks back-to-back threes.
He's tough. He is tough, George.
There's the confidence in McVay. Well, he looks to go again. He's got young Bowen. Takes his time, goes to the left, and he's got 8 points in a row for the Jack Jumpers.
He's tough, man. He's got the size. He can put the ball onto the floor.
We said no Shea Illy as well as John. Oh, two out the pass from Doyle and Hook Porty. Again, protecting the rim. Yep.
Look at this pass, though. Milton Doyle reads the situation perfectly. He knew Hook Porty was coming over. Chris Levick just too slow to get it up.
That timing is unbelievable.
Got two of the best rim protectors in the competition out here tonight. Magnat, the other end is Golding. Knocks down his second triple by his high standards, but bounced back with the 24 points against the Breakers. Chris Levick has got the range. That's Clint Steiner, in fact.
Speaking of shooters, he can let it fly.
He does spread the floor and open up their driving lane.
Both coaches have turned to their benches. Cameron just shows a bit of composure for the youngster. Nice finish.
Playing for the New Zealand national team. This guy here.
Fix it too. Don't know if he lost all of it, but he lost most of it. That's why he's currently dealing with a swollen mouth as well. But it's been a very promising start for the next start.
Might just have to bypass interviews with Hippoy tonight. Bulls.
When I see these teams play, I always look at it like a chess match with the coaches. Dean does his thing, Ross does his thing.
Well, that's just right there, coach. It's beautiful action. They run the exact same play, but rather than the flex cut, they go and they down screen for the shot. Beautifully executed.
Every loss this season is by being 8 points or less. Yeah, that for Tassie. There's McDonald going high off the glass, but there's Lee to clean it up. Put Porty back on the floor. Pete Hawley told us he can have his hands full with that Magne and Lee. Double team. And again, some good defense. Crawford looking to use his speed. Great ball movement from Tassie.
Split the gap with the pass. And again, they're hedging high. Unless you've got some weak side help, that's going to be on.
They've certainly woken from their slumber. Oh, down 11-1 early, and now they lead by four.
Milton Doyle. Yeah, no, you're right.
While you two discuss that, I'll get down to court side.
No, you're right.
Pete Hooley was in the Tassie huddle.
Yeah, guys. Oh my word.
Yes, sir. Porty, take that one.
Well, he's in no man's land. He was
not easy, is it? It's tough for this Melbourne United side to just continue to keep buttering up week after week.
It is, but what it tells him is if we can win without our some of our starters or being on the road.
14 points a game at home, 21 on the road. He's had a nice start tonight. 9 points on 50% from the field as Krebs finally gets one to four.
That's a pretty shot.
Put Porty's out of the game, so Melbourne United counter with their small lineup.
There's McVay. There's the energy. Gazy.
There he is. Captain.
Courtside to Pete Hawley.
Hey, guys, you're talking about Hook Porty going to the bench and the way they're going to play Fabian.
Not sure. That's a risky policy because I understand you've got to protect the player, but it's a long time to be sitting on the bench.
Especially if you expect for him to come in and do something in the second half. You got to let him touch that floor just a little bit. Maybe show a little bit of trust in your player.
Crawford answers the other end, especially when he played the 30 minutes last week for Magnate. Looked like maybe they were going to release the shackles on him.
Just so you stay connected with the game, the feel of the game, the pace of the game.
The blood flow in your legs.
We got a
shot was still there.
Well, was it though? I think if you look at the replay, the ball had gone into the rim, but maybe not.
We did. We looked and it was still in the air, just gazing you close.
Is that right? Okay, I'll just have to get Adam Ford onto that one as well.
Crawford this time playing facilitator for Krizlovic.
Great pass.
Nice. It's that slip pass, and again, it's on Melbourne United be playing them, and they're doing a good job of picking them off.
11 assists on their 16 field goals for the Jack Jumpers as Clark again helps himself to another two. First United player in double digits.
And even though that's a tough shot, that's what you want to do. You want to make him shoot twos and not threes. Once he starts knocking on those threes like that, then it's over.
Matthew Dellavedova down the other end. The penetration, the help.
Crawford playing facilitator. Three assists. Jordan Crawford to go these 11 points. As Dellavedova threw it up for Travis.
Came in and helped out.
Again, good ball movement outside. Steindl again, I should say.
Then they release. Clark was there, but then when they recover, straight away the unselfish play and the kick out.
Still struggling a little bit from long range. Crawford feeling good about himself. Pulls up in transition. He's got 16.
He dropped that one from the sky.
We had the closeout, so we had to adjust to put a little extra arc on it. And wow. There's that passing action right there. That is on point.
10-point lead. How do Melbourne United get back into this one, boys?
Well, it starts at this end of the floor, and that's not the sort of stuff that they would like. Come out, splash a three. There's some decent things happening, notwithstanding the three-point shooting problems.
Clark gets that one to fall.
Simple plays that are working for them. And Melbourne are overplaying a lot of these plays, and they're finding ways of scoring.
Well, there's been a lot more cheap action, and they've picked them off. Slip.
But wide open.
Gonna be.
So they're doing all this, the Jack Jumpers, without Milton Doyle having any influence. As Crawford's doing all the damage.
But seems to have paid off dividends to start the third.
There's Crawford. That's going to count. And he's doing as he pleases. Then he puts a little shimmy on.
That was directly the shimmy. So I think he actually says.
Deflect from the fact that Melbourne United are down by 24 points.
Ooh.
And there's Magnate.
Magnate said no, sir.
He's giving nothing away.
So here's the block.
Because you have proven you can be wrong.
Oh. That, when was it? 74.
Magnate again swats that one away.
It's not fair. It's not fair.
That's his third. He's loving it. Absolutely nothing.
You know, he's one of the players. When you think. But I think that it's someone that Brian Gorgeous should be taking a look at when you think of what the Boomers actually need. But I can't remember when this season in particular where the Melbourne United struggled so much on the offensive end.
McVay has been strong all night. Cameron getting some minutes. Newley, good feed, good find to Clark. Vidanovic, he wants Krizlovic. He likes the matchup. Gets downhill, uses his speed. And there's the hustle and scramble again.
Well, this is just, you got really five guards on the floor now. To count Brad Newley, now I know he's playing a little bit more.
Steindl. Crawford's been ultra aggressive all night. Up to 24 points now.
Melbourne United had a bad night. They've had a bad night because of what the Jack Jumpers have done. Wow.
There's Bob knocking down a triple. He wanted it back. Instead, Magnay goes at it alone. Throws it off the top of the backboard. With a wry smile. Everything's falling their way tonight for the Jack Jumpers.
Well, they've had the good combination with Lee really playing well in that first half. This, oh!
Okay. We got two wrong men.
Good. Have a look at the shot here. When you're having a good night, these types of things. He said, I got you, Luke. Send your crew in. And he was there and made himself available and spoke very nicely about the big Luke Longley as Drimmick knocks down the three ball.
Nice. Yeah. Out there.
Yeah. He's had a few issues with MJ.
Yeah. And so he should have.
There's a wedding coming up, isn't there?
Hook Porty with a finish.
Force himself into the contest while things are rolling for
better
the Jackets.
Better man than me.
Yeah, that's true.
We're up 20. I've got to get it up.
And that is his strength, isn't he, Milton Doyle? Yeah. He plays to what the game's giving him.
Some ownership. See, so it's an air ball, but Chris doesn't put his attention into Drimmick, and as such, gets an easy two. Tough.
There's Golding.
Tough shot.
That's a consistent number for him throughout the whole season, knocking down those 4 3-pointers. Yes. Just taking the 10 attempts, which they did want to try and get from him. As now Doyle gets in on the act. Morty, talk about they've lost 4 of those 6. And it's going to be another one tonight. So it'll be 5 of 7. When they concede 95, they've been beaten. A pretty familiar 5 on the floor at the moment. Delvedova, Hook Porty, Bowen, Clark, and Golding. Yes, Hook Porty getting some points in this fourth quarter. Up to 13 now with his 7 rebounds.
And one's fresh, good to go.
Yes, Doyle. Just giving the crowd something late.
That's smooth.
Continuing to play tough defense. Smashing on the glass.
Is that a pass?
Is that going to be a pass?
They're still 9 of 13. They're not out of it. Now, they need to be a radical turnaround in form. But if you take their form from early on in the season, can we give Jewel Footlocker players of the game?
Let them split it, bro. Let them split it. It's up to you. You're Andrew Gaze, yo. You can do what you want. Give the whole team. Give it to the whole team.
No, I think there's got to be a... Geez, there's a good argument.
Oh, there's Lee. He's got a double-double tonight. As they bring out all the starters.
Count back.
We're going to give...
Well, it's a draw, but on a...
Get off the fence, Drew.
On a
good name. Get off the fence.
On a count back, I'm going to go... They just sign and they'll keep it as a trophy. I remember the time I was co-player of the game.
Oh. Set me up.
This is Walter Brown. Got some players on the floor. Joe Bairstow, Lockie Barker getting some minutes as well.
We had Lockie Barker as a development player when we were at Sydney. And gee, did some of the battles he had with Jerome Randall and Kevin Lish.
And Jason Green.
Oh. Had an injury issues playing for Frankston last season in the NBL 1, but he's a quality player. In fact, Brad Muir's going to be back with Frankston.
They've been comprehensively outplayed tonight. The Tassie Jack Jumpers have defended the island. They bounce back in a big way after the heartbreaking loss.